Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to create a React app and configure the React dashboard layout component within it. A dashboard is a visual display of multiple panels, arranged on a single screen, so that several metrics can be monitored at a single glance. In this video, I will show you how to add a dashboard layout component to a React app using the panels property. I will also explain how to add multiple panels and configure them in a structured layout. Finally, you will see how to drag and resize the panels dynamically. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the npx create React app command. I provide the app name, my React app. I want to create the React app with TypeScript, so I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the dashboard layout component, I will type the command npm install at Syncfusion / EJ2 React Layouts --- save. Let's wait for the package to install. Before using a Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To see where to generate a trial license key, refer to the link in the description below. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. After that, I import the React dashboard layout component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Layouts package. I include the dashboard layout component tag. As you know, panels are the building blocks of the dashboard layout component. So, I add panels to it by defining an object called panels. Within this object, I can add n number of panels. Now, I am going to add single panel. Therefore, let me include a panel by setting the ID property with the value panel1. Then, I assign this object value to the panels property. I open the app.css file and replace the default styles with the necessary Syncfusion material CSS reference for the dashboard layout component. Save the changes and run the application using the command npm start. Looking at the dashboard layout, it has been rendered with a single panel. Next, I will show you how to define a header and the content of this panel. To add a title, I add the header property with the value panel1. To add content for this panel, I add the content property and give the value as content of panel1. See in the dashboard now, the panel is rendered with the header and content. Similarly, I am going to add 3 more panels to the dashboard. For that, I just copy the previous panel coding and paste it here. Then, I change the IDs, headers, and content for the newly added panels. To align the header and content in the panel, I open the app.css file and override the base classes ePanelHeader and ePanelContent by setting TextAlign and MarginTop styles to those classes. You can see that the dashboard layout renders with 4 panels with headers and content. By default, the panels are rendered with one after the other, vertically in descending order. If I want to position these panels in a defined layout structure, I can use the columns property. This property will define the number of columns to be created in the dashboard. I would like to create 3 columns here. So, I set the columns property in the dashboard layout component tag and set the value to 3. Then, I need to set the column position for each panel to render it in the desired column. For example, if I want to render a panel in the first column of the dashboard, I need to set its column position value to 0, since the column position values start from 0 in the dashboard layout component. For the second panel, I set the column value to 1. For the third panel, I set the column value to 2. Since I created only 3 columns in the dashboard, I need to place panel 4 in one of these columns. I will add the fourth panel to the second column by setting its value to 1. Now looking at the dashboard, panel 1 is rendered in the first column, panels 2 and 4 are rendered in the second column, and panel 3 is in the third column. Like this, I can also set the row position of each panel. For example, if I want to display panel 2 in the first row and panel 4 in the second row, I need to set the appropriate row value. In panel 2, I add the row property and set its value to 0. In panel 4, I set the row value to 1. Like the columns, the row position also starts at 0. Looking at the dashboard now, panel 2 is displayed in the first row and panel 4 is displayed in the second row. Next, I will show you how to customize the width and height of the panels in the dashboard using the sizeX and sizeY properties. The sizeX property is used to set the width, and sizeY property is used to set the height in terms of number of cells. I would like to increase the height of the panel 1 and width of the panel 4. So, I add the sizeY property in panel 1 and set its value to 2. Then I add the sizeX property to panel 4 and set its value to 2. You can see in the dashboard layout, the size of those panels has changed accordingly. Next, I will show you how to reorder the panels using the drag and drop feature. Here, I drag panel 1 and drop it over panel 2. Panel 1 will push aside panel 2 and replace it without disturbing the layout structure. To disable the drag and drop functionality in the dashboard layout, I add the allow dragging property and set its value to false in the dashboard layout component tag. Now, when I try to drag panel 1, I am not able to drag. Next, I will explain the resizing functionality. Using this feature, you can resize the panels dynamically through UI interactions using the resizing handlers. To enable the resizing, I add the allow resizing property and set its value to true. You can see the resizing handles for each panel when I hover over it. It allows you to resize the panels dynamically. I can also restrict the resizing of panels within a particular region. MinSizeX and MinSizeY are the minimum height and width values beyond which I cannot shrink the panel's size. Similarly, MaxSizeX and MaxSizeY are the maximum height and width values beyond which I cannot stretch the panel's size. To demonstrate, I will restrict the resizing for panels 1 and 4. For panel 1, I set the MinSizeY to 1, and max size y to 2. For panel 4, I set the min size x to 1 and max size x to 2. Looking at the dashboard now, I can resize the height of panel 1 only to between size 1 and 2. When I try to shrink it beyond size 1, it does not go smaller. I can only resize the width of panel 4 to between sizes 1 and 2 as well. When I try to stretch it beyond size 2, it will not get bigger. In this video, I have shown you how to add a dashboard layout component to a React application. You have seen how to configure the dashboard layout using columns, sizeX, and sizeY properties, and how to interact with the dashboard panels by dragging and resizing them. If you would like to see the working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.